Welcome to the 3-minute series. This is unit number 12 on the Gestalt experiment. So we say there's four pillars in Gestalt, one of which is the Gestalt experiment. There's also field theory, dialogue, and awareness. So in Gestalt, we use the experiment to explore awareness, but we do this not just through talking, through enacting, through embodying, through taking something that's a theme that the person talks about and trying it out. The experiment's about experiential learning. So we're not teaching the client, we're helping them discover for themselves through new experience. The experiment works by offering the right mix of challenge and support, because we say the experiment is a kind of a safe emergency. So we want to put the person into a bit of an emergency mode. We don't want to just have business as usual. We want to try out something new and different and risky, and something maybe they've never done before, or speak in a tone of voice that they would never normally use. We create the safety for them to do that. We set up a structure of an experiment for them to try that. Often we do it with them. And at the same time, as we're providing the risky element, we're also providing a lot of support, because we don't want to just traumatize people or make it too difficult for them. If they have, you know, if they have a fear of flying, we might say, okay, well, let's imagine we're in the airplane right now, and, you know, I'm next to you in the seat and the pilot's about to take off. I mean, it's an imaginary experiment, but it often brings up the feelings that the person has of fear, and then we can help them breathe and stay present and talk to us and hold a hand or whatever it is. I mean, a real life experiment would, and some therapists do this, would be to go on the plane with the person. But often that's not actually necessary. You can do a lot in these sort of recreations or kind of even imaginary experiments, because what we do is we're not just concerned with getting somewhere. We want to support the person to bring more awareness, to pay attention to what they're feeling, to support them in that process. So the experiment in Gestalt is very much about creativity. It's originally Fritz Perls came up with the two chairs, and for, I don't know, several decades that became Gestalt. But that was just one experiment that he designed. In fact, the best kind of experiments come out of the interaction between the therapist and client. They get made up in the moment. They suit the theme of the therapy session. They suit who the client is. They're kind of tailor-made. They're always consensual. We say, hey, how about this? I've got an idea. Would you like to try this out? And then we support them through it. So we don't just impose them or just direct them through the experiment. Though people do need some kind of guidance, like if we do a two chairs, you know, to swap between talking to their mother and or between two polarities or something. But the experiment can take any form, and it's a kind of a fun part of Gestalt. Even if there's some heavy topic, we can still kind of play with it a little bit in the experiment. And through that attitude of creativity and playfulness, we can take very difficult topics and we can kind of not lighten them up, but bring awareness, bring like fresh air into the topic and new experiences. If someone's depressed, then I don't know, we might experiment with that. We might say, okay, I'll be the depressed person. I'll be the one who's difficult to get up, and you be, you know, the spouse who's trying to wake you up. And, you know, so that's a way to swap polarities, for instance, and they can step out of being the depressed person into the person who's kind of trying to help the depressed person. So there's an infinite number of possibilities, and it's a fairly unique aspect of Gestalt, which originally derives from psychodrama.